Friends, today we are going to take a topic light, reflection and refraction. This is the name of the chapter. Now, first we should know what is light. Light is a form of energy which gives us sensation of sight. When a light falls on objects and it is reflected, and this reflected light is received by our eyes and we are able to see the object. So the sensation of sight is due to the light. So we can define the light as a form of energy which produces sensation of sight. Now there are many phenomena related to the light, the reflection and refraction. Today we are going to talk about the reflection. Now what is reflection? Now it is a phenomenon of a phenomenon of bouncing back of light. When the light falls on an object, let's say the light falls on the object, and it is reflected, bounced back in the same medium, and this is known as the reflection of light. So reflection of light, it is a phenomenon of bouncing back of light in the same medium on striking a surface of any object. Let us study the laws of reflection. There are two laws of reflection. This we can see as a plane. PQ is a plane mirror here, and this is the incident ray striking at B on the plane mirror PQ, and BM is the normal, and BC is the reflected ray after striking the this incident ray strikes at B. This is the reflected ray. So AB is the incident ray, BM is the normal, and BC is the reflected ray. Now the first law, that is the incident ray. This is the incident ray, normal to the mirror at the point of incidence B, and the reflected ray. These all lie in the same plane. If we take a mirror here like this, and this ray of light AB, it strikes at PQ at B, and this is the normal, and this is the reflected ray, that is BC. This will lie in the same plane. So board is a plane surface. So all of them lie in the board only. So this shows that the incident ray, the normal to the mirror at the point of incident, and the reflected ray all lie in the same plane. Now we should know what is angle of incidence and angle of reflection. The angle between the incident ray and the normal is known as angle of incidence, denoted by I. And the angle between the reflected ray and the normal is known as angle of reflection, denoted by R. And this law, second law, states that the angle of incidence, that is this, is equals to the angle of reflection. That means I is equals to R. So the angle of incidence equals to angle of reflection. Now let us take one question based on the laws of reflection. A ray of light falls on a plane mirror making an angle of 30 degree with the mirror. What is the angle of reflection? In this, most of the student answers that the angle of reflection is 30 degree. But this is not correct. Now in this question, it is given that the ray of light falls on a plane mirror making an angle of 30 degree. That means the incident ray is making an angle of 30 degree with the plane mirror. What is the angle of reflection we have to find? Now if this is angle is 30 degree, this where angle will become 60 degree, because we know that the angle between the normal and the mirror or any reflecting surface is 90 degree. So this is 30, so this will become 60 degree. So now we know that angle of incidence is how much? That is equals to 60 degree. And according to the laws of reflection, the angle of incidence is also equals to angle of reflection. So this angle will also become 60 degree. So angle of reflection will be equals to 60 degree. Now let us take one more question based on the laws of reflection. A ray of light is incident normally on a mirror. What is the angle of reflection? In this question, it is given that a ray of light is incident normally on a mirror. This is a normal we have drawn. As we know that the angle between the mirror and the normal is 90 degree. A ray of light, that means this is a ray of light incident normally on the mirror. That means it goes on the mirror. It goes on the normal. Now we have to find what is the angle of reflection. Now this is the incident ray also, and this is a normal also. So the angle of incidence will be angle of incidence, that is denoted by I, will be 0 degree. It is not 90 degrees as some of the students think that this angle is 90 degree. No, the angle between the incident ray and the normal is known as angle of reflection. So this is the incident ray as well as the normal. So the incident ray is going on the normal. So the angle of incidence is 0 degree. So and we know the laws of reflection, the angle of incidence and equals to angle of reflection. So angle of reflection will also be equals to, that is denoted by R, that will be equals to I. The angle of reflection is equals to angle of incidence, and angle of incidence is almost 0 degrees. So angle of reflection will also be 0 degrees.